Hi, today Sterdon. This it is what seems to be a master compass indicator for big Soviet aircraft. As you can see, we have compass dial, a big box, and a big multi-pin connector. Here is the model number for you and serial number. 46,331. At the back we just have a cover for the wires and one extra screw here for the main cover. So before I remove this main cover, I will take the opportunity of the Sterdon to clean inside here, because in fact it is very dirty, it is even moldy inside behind the glass. So for this particular glass, there is a circlip all around, and there is a little hole here that would allow to insert a tool and pop out this spring circlip thing. And now I need to pull the glass. For it, I just took the suction cup from my car GPS, and I hope it will work. Yes, easy enough. So we have, in fact, the little needle here. I would love to be able to pull it, and at the same time get the opportunity of removing this dial here, but I am not sure at all if it will come or not. So I will try very gently to pull it. And yes, I was not far from stopping, but it did finally come. Okay. And now I can have opportunity of removing this dial for the first time ever and having a look at behind it. Let me find a matching screwdriver. No, it is too big. Not too big, even. Okay. I can try this small broken one. Yes. So I'm not sure what I will find behind this dial. So it looks like we have one stuck screw. Or maybe two. Working on this thing is really not easy. Okay, this one is loose, so it did remove the paint over the screw, but it is not a big deal. I can always, I have paint pens, so I can easily repair little paint spots. Okay. Three screws are off, and here is what, oh, excuse me, perfectly out of the frame. Here is what we have, not much to see. Just two Amberton pieces and one more cover, but here the screws, it looks like they are glued with epoxy. And they will not come easily, so I will not bother with them. Okay, I will just clean and reinstall the glass. Here we are, much cleaner, so now time to remove the main cover. We have here at the back four screws for the... This one is totally loose by the way. For the terminals of the wire. So I did already do a very old video about this device, but it was in a low resolution or very bad in focus or such. So I am doing a new one in full HD for you. So as you can see, a regular setup, we have the wires soldered to a terminal board. We have wire clamps here, securing the wires in place, which I need to undo if I want to be able to pull out the case. And by the way, this piece is a very nice die cast aluminium. I will probably replace the four screws here, which are not in good condition, when I will reassemble. If I find screws, four screws of the same design and of the correct length, which is always a problem. Usually one screw you find, two, maybe three, but four. It is always, and I remove the last one here. Okay. So now I can, so the cover is now just completely loose, and I can easily remove it. It is a little bit bent, but luckily it is not bent enough to avoid removing it. Sometimes it happens and it is very annoying. So here is what we have inside. As you can see, here is a seal. Here I will remove it also. It will be out of the way. And it looks like this seal is in pretty bad condition too. Some kind of moldy, as you can see, so I will clean it. So here is what we have. As you can see, a very serious metal work, framework. We have here electronics. And here the business end with a lot of rotary contacts. So I guess we will start. We have a closer look here where the cables come in. So you can see they are connected to this terminal board. Big wire loom here. Arriving here on this PCB, which is mainly covered with relays. This is a relay. The other things are at the back too. We have a big glass metal diode here. And it is all. Here we have two wire wound precision resistors, it seems, and at the back, one capacitor. We have a few resistors here at the bottom. And the wire looms are distributed to relay boards here. And here we have this big cylinder, which seems to be some kind of a motor. But there is really a big number of wires going to it, as you can see. Here is the model number of the device. It is upside down, but you can see DJG-05 0.5 TB with a serial number. So this is connected to a set of rails in this brass frame and connected to the main assembly here. But before we check this main assembly here, we have here the other electronics. So two circuit boards and this metal piece with two power transistors mounted on the sides. So it must ask like the heatsink. On these two PCBs, the bottom one is not very interesting. We just have green capacitors, debug transistor here, and a few other capacitors, diodes, and so on. But on this one, not sure how far you will be able to see, we have this green block and another bigger one at the back. So we have six contacts on each one. So maybe they are just transformers. Precision resistor here, more debug transistors. And it is all for this piece. So on here is the obviously the business end. You have this is wire one potentiometer with three wipers here, as you can see. Another one here with a very fine wire wand here, over precision resistor. We have here a whole bunch of rotary contacts. 10 of them, something like this. With wipers divided in four groups. We have one here, one here at the back, and two here at the top. These ones are easier to see for you. And we have the pieces we were able to see with the dial removed. These two Humberton things. And there is more wires going in the front. So, quite interesting. It looks like this whole assembly here can be removed with this screws and it will pull back. But of course, there is the whole shaft in the way, so it is not going to happen. Here, you can see. It is interesting, the wipers are attached to this piece here. I tried to look at the viewfinder at the same time, but it is not easy, believe me. This piece is holding the wipers for the potentiometers. And we can see the body of the instrument is made of two parts. There is the main one here with the front, and this one is secured with a number of screws. And also, of course, the back panel holding the terminal contacts for the wire loom. About the wire loom, very thick and stiff. Not sure if I have a ruler here, but trust me. To give you an idea, it is 2 centimeters thick. It is 3 centimeters wide, and here is the size of a plug, 7 centimeters long. And without the external pieces, it is already not far from 4 centimeters in diameter. So really, really serious stuff. And we have a number of what seems to be silver-coated contacts. Okay, very big wire harness here in the middle, crossing the back circuit board here. There is a hole in the circuit board, and the wire harness is actually going through the circuit board. It is quite weird because in fact you have this wall corner which is not used, and which you could have removed and make space for the wires. But maybe at the same time it serves the purpose of keeping very well the wire harness in place. Quite interesting. And also there is some quality stamps here. And we have 8 relays on this PCB. There is a circular one in metal here. The little on the cube relay here. Okay, so very interesting device. This one I got it as always from German eBay, but it is a very a long time item I have. Very long time, probably from the early 2000s or something like this. Maybe not after 2004 or at least. Okay, so I would love to know what there is in this area here, but it seems almost impossible again to take it apart with no damage. As you can see, it is very complicated, so. But it is always the same thing with items in quite good condition. If you want to keep them for collecting, you cannot take them apart completely without being sure of being able to reassembling. In particular, here we have no connectors, all the wires are hardwired to terminal blocks and such, so it does not help at all for investigating, as you can see. Not a single internal connector on this thing. Everything is soldered in place. Very labor intensive, probably for any repair. It is a luck they did at least provide a main connector for the instrument. Okay, so thanks for watching, and don't forget to check my other videos, to like, subscribe, share, and so on. Click on the ads also. Bye bye.